Hello and welcome to A New Way to Museum. I am Alicia. I am the naturalist here at the Sternberg Museum. So that means I take care of all of our live animals that we have here. So today we are going to talk about our wood rat and how we enrich her. So for those of you who don't know, a wood rat and a pack rat are the same thing. So pack rats are very well known for just destroying everything and taking stuff from humans and stuff like that. So when we talk about having a wood rat or a pack rat here, we have to do lots of things to give her good enrichment. So mainly we have reptiles and amphibians, and they do need enrichment. They're a lot easier than mammals. So Clover is so much fun. She loves all kinds of human things. So we could give her pretty much anything we find at the stores or anything like that. So as you can see, she is quite adorable with her big beady eyes. So Clover is a vegetarian. So mainly she eats fresh veggies and vegetables and anything we can get for her. But we always like to make it fun for her to get these food. So we have this cute metal vase right here, and I like to stick food at the bottom of it. And then I'll either take sticks or fake plants like I'm using today and weave it through the holes in the vase so that she has to get through these in order to get the food at the bottom. And I also like to put some pine cones on top because she loves her pine cones. She really just enjoys moving them around and playing with them and, of course, dropping them in her water bowl all the time. So I like to set this up in her cage so that she either has to climb up it and into it to get her veggies, or most of the time she will knock it over. So it's very, very fun for her. So something else we do in order to hide her snacks is we have this little dog treat toy that some of you might have for your dogs. So exactly what you would think we would use it for, we are gonna hide treats in it. So most of our animals here obviously eat dead mice and stuff like that, or insects, whereas Clover, like I said, is a vegetarian. So I get to make food for her. So I made these blueberry oatmeal peanut butter balls that she loves, as well as our pet rats and mice love to eat. So I'm going to stick these in her little dog ball, and I'm going to put this paper towel in there so that she has to pull it out before she can get her snacks. So usually she can't obviously fit in this thing, so she's gonna have to roll it around until the treats fall out. So we can also do this with blueberries or strawberries or stuff like that. So something else I like to do is I take anything human-like, cloth piece, shirts, towels, anything that we have that we can't really use here anymore because they're just old. And I will give those to her so that she can add them to her little nest. So today I'm giving her these little pieces and she will add them to her yellow towel that she has claimed as her own that she will never let me take away. She will play tug of war with it. So something else I like to do is I take yarn and I use paper clips or the clothespins, and I will stick them all over her cage. So she loves pulling them off of stuff. In this case, I'm putting them on her food bowl and I'm tying some yarn around it so that she has to really pull the yarn out in order to get to her food, as well as just pull her paper clips off. And then she will also add those to her nest. So I also recently found this cute little mouse, rabbit, whatever kind of pet animal you'd get from a pet store, this little toy for them. And I'm going to attach it to the top of her cage, and it does smell like other rodents. So that'll probably give her some other enrichment to smell other animals that are kind of like her. And I'm just gonna hang it up here and she'll be able to chew on it. And as you can see, she's already taken good chunks out of her old one. And honestly, she will probably completely rip these apart and again, add it to her nest, what she loves to do. And then one thing I'm going to try today that I've never tried with her before is giving her this PVC pipe. So it is big enough that she can fit through it, and I'm gonna stick some food in there so that she knows that she can go into it, and it's gonna be kind of like a little burrow for her. So we clean her cage once a week because obviously she has her little bathroom and we wanna clean that up every now and then. And then I completely redo her cage and give her all kinds of new stuff once a week. And then every single day we will set these things back up or hide her food somewhere in her cage. So enrichment for her is an everyday task, and it is so much fun, especially when you guys see her running through and checking out her new stuff and exploring. And it just makes her really happy. And so she's a lot of fun. So today I'm also going to give her this cute little stuffed toy. I've never given her one before. So we will have to see what she does with it, whether she just leaves it be or if she tears it up. All right, guys. Well, that is all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. And hopefully we can see more of Clover in the future.
Thanks for joining us in A New Way to Museum with the Sternberg Museum of Natural History. If you enjoyed this video, like it and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell for notifications when we release a new video. Support us on Patreon for early access and exclusive content. You can also follow us on all our social media. Links are found in the description. Thanks for watching, and follow your curiosity to new discoveries.